I planned on it the whole time for it to be kind of like it is. The barn downstairs is a barn. I built it in 1971. And I was in the calf raising business at the time. But I wanted the top to be like it is. And so it's always been that way.
My dad is a hard worker. I think he just wanted a place that was big enough for everybody to meet in. You know, all the old timers in Syracuse know where Gary's barn is.
But we've had so much snow, we thought we'd just bring this camera out and show you.
Well, we poured the cement and then laid the cinder block. And I had a whole semi-load of logs brought down from Montana. But I had a contractor friend to come and actually helped us build the trusses.
He made all those milk can stools that we sit on to eat.
I think everywhere he went, he would just have his eye out for certain things that he wanted up in the barn. And it's almost like when he gets his mind onto something, he can't stop. I mean, there's never enough of them, I don't think.
Well, that shuffleboard, that slab is 21 feet long, and we had the forklift lifted up the back door, but I had about 10 guys that lifted it off the forklift and bring it through that back door. But the pool table was a different story. We had a little more trouble getting that up there because we took it up the stairs.
Look who just came in. Oh, and he's happy too.
Dad would so many times, I think up the ideas, but it was my mom who actually helped and carried out and did the work. I love that example in my life of them working together and supporting each other and being the main focus of each other's lives.
Happy Thanksgiving!
Happy Thanksgiving!
A lot of birthday parties, lots of weddings.
But our Christmas Eve has been a big thing since these kids was just, well, we started when they was all babies.
And Santa Claus would come and surprise us every year and bring us presents, and then they'd go put on their pajamas. And we've done that for years.
Merry Christmas!
One year we was having a New Year's party, and this guy and his wife had got feuding. So anyways, well, he spent the night, and his daddy-in-law was a salesman for the brickyard, and at that time,
and Gary knew him very well.
He was a good friend of mine, and he says, I want to see where Daryl spent the night last night in
the
barn.
Boys. I want to see in the barn where Daryl
spent. And he thought it was a barn.
I do look around and I think of the hours my dad must have spent in little projects putting that together just for us. He did it for his own enjoyment and because he loves things like that, but I know he did it with his family and mine.
Tell Grandpa, Merry Christmas, Grandpa!
We've always had a video camera and always taped the people that have been up there. And now when you watch those and you know that your grandma's gone, but you have this little piece of her up in the barn and you watch it, there's nothing like it because it was, you know, it's something that no one else has. No one else has a barn that they go to on Christmas, and we always did.
We had to do it over again, we'd have done it the same way.
Except to build a restroom.
By the time you sit, yeah, we would have a kitchen and running water
and an elevator.
Yeah, elevator for Grandpa back. Makes one trip up there and one trip back down now. That's all he can do.
I can't drink much now because I don't want to keep going up down the stairs.
You just got to get that on that tape, don't you?